But during the course of his investigation, we all know this, he came upon some roadblocks, and the roadblocks were put there by the President of the United States. He asked for permission to investigate the roadblocks. The roadblocks are called obstruction of justice. Obstruction of justice is any attempt, successful or not, to interfere with a federal investigation for a corrupt purpose. So if a lawyer files a complaint with a judge saying, tell the FBI to leave my guy alone because they're violating his constitutional rights, that's an interference with a federal investigation, but not for a corrupt purpose. That's to vindicate constitutional liberty. On the other hand, if the subject of a criminal investigation tells the people who work for him to lie to the FBI and falsify evidence so that the FBI will not find out whatever the subject doesn't want them to know, as Mueller said Trump did between 10 and 11 times, that is obstruction of justice, and it is for a corrupt purpose. The corrupt purpose is to keep the government at bay, to interfere with its investigation so that it won't get to the truth. This raises two questions. Is obstruction of justice an impeachable offense? We know it is because Nixon and Bill Clinton were both impeached for obstruction of justice. In the Nixon case, the articles of impeachment were voted on, and then he resigned. In Clinton's case, of course, there actually was a trial. Second question, can the president be prosecuted for obstruction of justice? Here's where I think Mueller dropped the ball. Mueller says the president can't be prosecuted because presidents can't be prosecuted. Well, presidents can't be prosecuted, then they're above the law. And we know a basic principle of American jurisprudence is no one is above the law. Surely an indictment could be had, and maybe they're not going to actually prosecute the indictment until after the president leaves office. But nobody can get away with that kind of lawbreaking.
This is Fox News' senior judicial analyst Andrew Napolitano making crystal clear what he believes the punishment for Trump should be in the aftermath of the special counsel probe. And he brings up a few important distinctions, poking holes in nearly every tenuous defense put forward by the White House. For example, he points out that while a lawyer might interfere in a federal investigation on behalf of his client, it's permissible as long as there's no corrupt intent. But that's not what happened with Trump, who is the subject of a criminal investigation and decided to interfere for a corrupt purpose, as he did on at least 10 occasions. And Napolitano points out, too, that these attempts to obstruct justice don't have to be successful. The mere act of endeavoring to obstruct is enough. So Trump might say, yeah, I tried to have Mueller removed, but Don McGahn wouldn't do it, so I'm in the clear. But yeah. Got some bad news about that. In fact, obstruction of justice or endeavoring to obstruct justice were both charges in Clinton and Nixon's articles of impeachment. So for Republicans to twist themselves into pretzels to claim that there's no precedent for this, or that this isn't legal, or at the very least, that this isn't impeachable, is complete head-in-the-sand nonsense. In fact, the only reason that Trump hasn't yet dealt with the consequences of what even this Fox News judge admits is a slew of illegal offenses is a political loophole. The Department of Justice leaned on guidance that said a sitting president cannot be indicted, and Trump knew that that was his safety net. In fact, his entire strategy was to claim that unless he was indicted, that he was totally exonerated, knowing that such a move was impossible. And then, lo and behold, as soon as Mueller failed to indict, because, again, he couldn't, Trump claimed complete and total exoneration. And Mueller himself said just that during the press conference, explaining that such a move was expressly forbidden under the purview of the DOJ, under which the special counsel's office operated, and was therefore unconstitutional.
It explains that under long-standing department policy, a president cannot be charged with a federal crime while he is in office. That is unconstitutional. Even if the charge is kept under seal and hidden from public view, that too is prohibited. The special counsel's office is part of the Department of Justice, and by regulation, it was bound by that department policy. Charging the president with a crime was therefore not an option we could consider.
And adding this for good measure.
If we had had confidence that the president clearly did not commit a crime, we would have said so.
And look, a potential indictment is still not out of the question. The special counsel's office did farm out multiple cases to different offices, including those in Washington, D.C., Virginia, and New York. So investigations into this administration are still ongoing. But ultimately, just like in the cases of Clinton and Nixon, the issue of Trump's misconduct is something to be settled by Congress. And that's a power that Mueller himself reiterated in his report, saying that Congress has the authority to prohibit a president's corrupt use of his authority in order to protect the integrity of the administration of justice. And that's what the White House was afraid of, which is why Bill Barr tried to take it upon himself to mislead the public and exonerate Trump when that responsibility explicitly fell to Congress.
After nearly 2 years of investigation, thousands of subpoenas, hundreds of warrants, and witness interviews, the special counsel confirmed that the Russian government sponsored efforts to illegally interfere with the 2016 presidential election, but did not find that the Trump campaign or other Americans colluded in those efforts. After carefully reviewing the facts and legal theories outlined in the report and in consultation with the Office of Legal Counsel and other department lawyers, the Deputy Attorney General and I concluded that the evidence developed by the special counsel is not sufficient to establish that the president committed an obstruction of justice offense.
But because Democrats were able to ensure that the largely unredacted report was released, the White House's attempts to mislead were unsuccessful. And look, clearly this entire scheme by the White House runs counter to the very core of our justice system, that no person, even the president, is above the law. Which is why Trump's house of cards seems ready to collapse. Between Mueller's carefully selected wording during his press conference, granting Congress the responsibility to impeach, and then with even a conservative judge on Fox News outright claiming that Trump ought to be indicted, whether it's now or after he leaves office, it seems that the White House's desperate spin machine isn't quite able to overcome the truth here. Because while Trump might think he's untouchable, he's about to learn pretty quickly that
no one is above the law.